people, welcome or welcome back to my channel. We're starting again with my base all done. This is gonna be an eye video. I'm gonna do a voiceover just to warn you all. But today is a special one because I'm collabing with a lot of gorgeous ladies. We're all in a Patreon group from Alex's Angels from Makeup with Alex Kate. And we're all doing this together, a little Valentine's Day look for our channels or Instagrams or anything. So all the handles of these lovely ladies will all be down below in the description box. Really looking forward to this, hoping that it will be fun and we all come up with amazing looks and look gorgeous. And yeah, it's so much fun. I love doing collabs. This is my third one now that I've done, but yeah, it's a lot of fun. I'll hope you enjoy. So we're all gonna do a Valentine's look and I'm gonna use my new Rose Metal Louis Cosmetics palette, which I just got from an amazing friend. Thank you so much. And I just had to pay shipping and that's it. So that's really amazing. Thank you so much. So yeah, we're doing this collab with this gorgeous palette. I'm gonna do a pinky look. It's inspired by a look I've seen on Instagram. I will link her here. Or here, I don't know where it is, but I'll put a picture up of my inspo pic and see what I wanted to achieve. I'm going to do it a little bit different with different colors, of course, but I don't know what she used because I just saw the picture. But that's the inspo. So yeah, I would like to be transparent about it as I did not come up with this look. I just copying it and changing it to my own. So yeah, hope you all enjoy that. I'm gonna put all this on my face. And yeah, I'm so happy that we're doing this collab. It's so much fun. And yeah, I hope you like my little inspirational video, my Valentine's video to this collab, all of you who are collabing with me. I'll try to link all the channels down below in the description box. So please check them out, go follow them, but also subscribe to my channel. Hit that notification bell, give me a comment, give me a like. It would mean so much to me and would so help my channel out. I'm feeling like I'm a little bit not going too fast this year, but I'm enjoying it and I'm having fun and I do love my life. So if you want to pick a live, I'm trying to do every Thursday a live on my channel, so that would be amazing. And yeah, I love you. And let's just go in with this palette. And let's start with the color Bittersweet, and we're gonna put this on my E42 from Sigma, because yeah, I love this brush at the moment. I'm just gonna pack on this gorgeous black and look at the one stamp, and that's the black on. Looks really nice. I'm going for a quite a nice look. Have you seen before with the heart shape into it? Let's hope I can do that and I can go there. And it looks like a heart. Yeah, you never know. Sometimes you have to do something different. So yeah, we're gonna pack on this black and look at that color. Just gonna be on the outer corner and we're gonna put it all the way into the inner corner to make nice dimensions in it. And yeah, I really like this black. Just packed on really nicely. There are probably blacks that are blacker than this, but for me it worked fine. Because yeah, you have to have a black that also works well with other colors and blends in. And Louis, you did amazing in this palette. Let's be real, let's tell you already now. Because wow, this is pigmented. Love the black, loved it all, put it on. So yeah, really fun to do a collab with a lot of other ladies. This will all be... all of our videos will be on at the same time. At least I'm gonna try, because I'm still editing when I do the voiceovers. The last thing I have to edit it in, and then I have to still get it on YouTube. And it's now 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and it has to be up at 6 UK time. It will be 7 here, so I have still 5 hours. But sometimes it doesn't go the way I plan, so we'll see how it's gonna go. So yeah, that's a little bit FYI to how I do it. Sorry if this bores you. But yeah, look at that black. It's just perfect. It just goes on so nicely. These shades all feel like butter and it's amazing. Of course, I did not swatch this palette. I just flecked it on my face the way I always do with my makeup. Because yeah, I don't know, that's the way I like it. Just a little bit intensifying the shade and more. And then we're gonna go blend it out. We're gonna use my 228 blending brush from Jessup. And we're just gonna go around the edges of the black, that's it, just to make them fade a little bit, because I want to go with pink further in. And I figured it would be easier to blend it together if I would blend this out a little bit. I don't know, because I never do this normally, because that often I don't use black, to be honest. Because it scares me a little bit, but it went okay. In the end, it went okay, I must admit. So yeah, blending this all together. Blending this all out so that it will be no harsh lines and a little bit easier to put pinky shades around it. At least that's what I think, and I think it worked. Worked the way I wanted it to work. So yeah, that's good. I like that. And yeah, just keep it until I think that it's blended out enough and there's no harsh lines. And then we're gonna go in with this gorgeous pinky Fall For You burgundy color. Don't know, I love it. And then go in with the E27 brush again from Sigma. This is a little bit of a flat brush, which you can't see, but it's really easy to get it exactly in the place I want because it's not that big. It's nice and small. I really like this for blending together with other shades. And look at that pigment. Look at that color, just on top of the black, and it's just bam, it's there. I really love the pigmentation. These colors are so good. I'm definitely gonna use the brownie shades next time because I want to see how much those blend together. But these pinkies, oh, I really love them. They're so good. Look at that, the blend, and they just blend in the black like butter. It doesn't have anything, and you can still see the black. You still see that it's on top of it. Just intensify the pink, I feel like. It doesn't do anything other. That's just amazing. I love this. I love these colors. They mix together so well. And of course, pink is my favorite color. I didn't use it that much on my eyes. Because, yeah, I've done a lot of looks. But no really pinks lately. I did purples and I did do a pink inside a look. But not all pink. So, yeah, I really like it. Looks good again to do a pinky. And yeah, look at these shades. It's just so good. Really love it. It's just intense. And yeah, I don't know. I just good. Keep intensifying it because, yeah, I don't know. Keep playing with it. Oh, I'm sorry for blowing in, but it's, again, it's my own palette. I'm not going to use it on anybody else, just on me. So who cares? I certainly don't, because otherwise I would have not done it, probably. So yeah, keep blending it till I've got the perfect intensity. Doesn't need it really, but yeah, that's me. I love blending. So yeah, just keep blending and look at the colors. Just so intense. I love it. Now we're going in with the color Date Night, this gorgeous light pink, to blend it all out. And we're gonna do this on my M562 brush from Morphe. And what I do like about this palette as well, because look, we're going to put this all around the other shades. They blend out to each other perfectly. And the difference between the colors are also really good. I think they're perfect for blending each other out. And yeah, I wanted to, of course, keep it pinky because this is a Valentine's Day look. And collab with all these other lovely ladies. And yeah, that's why I wanted to do pink. Because Lois Cosmetics has another palette, the Gone Rogue one, and after seeing this one first, because even though I really hesitated, wanted to use the other as well, but I didn't, I really want to use the other now, because I want to know how good it is, and how the other does, and yeah, I have the palette in front of me, because I just got them in from an amazing friend, Missa. Thank you so, so much. It's gorgeous. This pigmentation is just, well, mind-blowing. Really good. Really love it. Works so well. Probably not gonna, Lois not gonna watch this, but if you do, wow. Respect. Amazing. Look at that pink. And you still see the other shades. It's just, no matter, I have a lot of palettes that if you put it on another shade, you have to go back in with the other shades, but you don't. Look at all the colors, all the three colors still perfectly on there, just blending with each other. And yeah, it's amazing. It's incredible. I really like this. If you want this palette, it's worth it. I think she has at the moment a sale for 14% off, which ends today. So I don't know until if she keeps it until 12 o'clock at night, because this is going to be, of course, 6 UK time. So we'll see. But if you want, then check it out. Maybe it's still on there. And even that, it's not that expensive. It's £19.95, if I'm correct. So yeah, get it if you want it. It's good. I love the pinks, they're so good. I haven't tried the browns yet, to be honest, but I definitely will. I'm gonna try the browns when I see how good these are. I'm gonna cut my crease in the heart shape. This is gonna be in the basic Cute in Carol from P. Louise, Cute in Carol, Cute in Coral, and the hashtag 7072 brush that came with the acid rain bases I've got. I'm just gonna blend. I figured it would be easier to use a little color already, and I didn't have a pinky one, so I figured this corally one would work as well, and it did. I think it worked better than if I would have used just a normal Rumor 01 base, because this already has a little bit of color in it, so I feel like it made it pop a little bit more. I do want to try all the shades now, and all the acid rains, and all the how the other paints called, I don't know, but oh, they're so good. So yeah, I want so much makeup and I have no money, but mostly that's the problem. When you have no money, there's so much makeup coming out, and when you have the money, there's just, I don't know, would feel like it. Probably isn't, but that's what it feels like. And yeah, we're gonna cut my crease. Be careful, because I want that heart to be perfection. So yeah, this takes some time. I could have speeded this up, but I don't know. I always feel like it's easier to see the whole process in this normal speed and glory. I know I speeded up in a lot of my beginning videos, but I've decided to stop doing that and just do this. It's just a 20-minute video, so not that long. So please watch it till the end. If you came to this, just watch it till the end. Just go it. And if you don't want to watch it completely, you can go at 2x the speed and you'll still be here. I'm not allowed to tell this from YouTube, I've heard. Ah, well. So yeah, I really like this. God, grease, look at it. Takes a lot of time though, because I wanted to have precise, so I took my time as well. So that's not just take time. Then we're gonna put in the first part of his heart. Look at that. First part in. Just a little bit good stamping. Yeah, we have to be careful, because otherwise you go wrong and this look comes out really weird. At least that's what I think. And now it just works. This crease took a lot of time. But yeah, I wanted to do this heart. It looks so cool the way she did it. And yeah. I'll also link her channel, her YouTube, if, I don't know if she had YouTube, I mean her Instagram handle down below. I'll put it on there, so you can link that, click at that and see the original look and its full glory. Because yeah, I did do it a little bit different. She had a more powerful and a lot of highlight on, and I didn't want that. I wanted to be a little bit, you know, technically, I would still wear this for a Valentine's Day night. I don't have a Valentine's date or a Valentine, but if I would have had one, I could have worn this and I would have liked it. Not that the guy would have noticed that it's a heart on my eye, but I would have noticed. And I technically added the makeup for myself. If the guy doesn't like it, then I'm probably going to be things I don't like about that guy either. So, yeah, probably would have noticed, but I wouldn't have done it. Well, I like it. It's good. Just took a lot of time. Like you can see, because we're still at it. And I'm still talking rubbish, so yeah. So please, if you enjoy these videos, subscribe to my channel. Hit that notification bell, give me a like, give me a comment. It would be so amazing. Would be so amazing, really would be. Yeah. Going careful. Making it nice and a heart shape. And I think it came out. I think you can see in the end it's a heart. If you can't see it, please do tell me. But if you can, also tell me. I like to know those things. I like to talk to my Instagram. I like to talk in person better, but I'm not that good at WhatsApp and Telegram and all those things. I keep forgetting to pop in and out. But well, I'm better at talking. I do a lot of my lives when I get to talk to all of you. Now we're going to go in with the color Hopeless Romantic. And we're going to put this, of course, on my shimmer brush, which is for me the 237 gesso brush. And we're going to pack this all over that hard cut crease. And look at it. It looks like the heart shape, right? I'm not wrong. Am I wrong? Please do tell me. But oh, and look at this color. It's so beautiful. That pinky, gorgeous shade packs on nicely. And of course, because the coral is already a little bit in it, you can at least I can still see it. It feels like it works better. At least to me. So yeah, pack it on. I love this palette, it's so good. And that shade, look at that gorgeous pinky shade. Just works so well. Oh, I love it. Yeah, be careful again, because otherwise you will be outside of the cut crease, which in this case would be annoying, because then you have to make the heart even bigger, because otherwise it's not a heart shape. So, and I wanted that, but yeah, just be careful and just take your time, like I did. Because, yeah, of course I did two eyes, but because I did the other eye as well, and you won't see it on the camera, because it's going to be the same as this one. So I want to have just one eye on camera. That's why also one of the reasons I mostly do voiceovers, because I always forget to stop talking when I go to the other eye. Yeah, but yeah, this is nice. I like this. I like doing it this way. Sometimes I won't, sometimes I will. I'm going to keep doing it because I enjoy this. And especially for looks like this with intricate hearts and everything on, it's just easier if I don't have to talk and can just pack the makeup on. It's just a little easier. And like you can see, this is perfectly on and all the other shades are still on there. So I don't have to identify anything. This is so amazing because look at it. It's just so gorgeous and so, I don't know, I love it. The colors came out amazing. I love how the look came out. It really looks like a heart in my eyes. So I'm quite proud of myself, to be honest, in a little bit. So yeah, we're going to go the bottom lash line and we're going to go in again with Bittersweet. This is going to be on my 234 Jesse brush. I'm just going to put it a little bit on the outer corner of my lower lash line. Just a little bit. Because I don't want to have it too black. So I'm just going to put on, like you can see, a little black at the side. Be careful with this, because otherwise the black will do too much and that would be a real shame and annoying. And yeah, just keep it in that outer corner, not further on. Then I'm going to go in with my black Maybelline liner on the same place as the black powder and then the Essence pink. And then we're going to go in with my Fall For You color in 234, just a brush with it and just pack this on. I would love to have shown you the putting me on the eyeliners, because I just put the black on the outer corner and the pink on the inner corner. But unfortunately, I was out of frame when I put it on, so I figured to cut it out. So yeah, this color around the other one, this is going to be completely over the eye. From back to forth, look at that gorgeous pinky shade. And then we're going back in with Date Night, again on the same 234 Jessa brush. This one and this brush, and put it on the other shades. And what I love about this is the color still on there. You don't have to I didn't have to re-intensify anything, at least in my eyes. And I think it looks amazing. I love the colors. That is going to be the last color I put on my eyes. It's going to be Self Love. This is going to be on my GS13 Jessa brush. This is Morphe and Jeffree Star. We're going to put this in the inner corner and on my brow bone, the last color, and look at those colors. I really love them. This eye look came out together like perfection, I think at least. I love this look. Complete perfect for Valentine's Day. Hope all of you all like it and appreciate it and enjoy doing this with me. And if you copied this from me or the other gorgeous woman that I'm going to put her link down below, then let me know. Going back to me from the past. That's my Valentine's collab look. All done. Ooh, I really, really love the outcome. I think it really does look, I don't know if you can see, but it really does look like a heart on my eye, because that was the plan. It was the picture I was going for. The colors are a little bit different than my inspo pic, but that's what I wanted to be. I wanted to be a little bit different than that, not exactly. Like the picture. I like this. This is a nice Valentine's Day look. This palette, I'll play with it more. This was just for the Valentine's collab, but it's really good. I don't know if I showed the beginning, the insides of it, but look at this. It's just beautiful. I really love it. I think this look is quite something. I love it. Came out really nice. I hope you enjoyed my little video. I hope that you're gonna follow everyone else who did it with me, this collab. It will be all over YouTube and Instagram. Again, all the channels will be down below and all the Instagram handles and everything will be down below in the description box, including what I've used on my face. All the products, the base products, everything will be on there. I hope you enjoyed it. Tell me if you got this palette, if you love it too, and if you used it for Valentine, for your Valentine. I'm single, so I'm not gonna go anywhere. I'm gonna go have dinner with my parents with these eye looks on, but they're used to me having extreme looks on my eyes, so yeah, I really like it. It really came out amazing, and this palette, it's so good. So yeah, on my lips I have the Huda Lip Contour in Trophy Wife, together with my NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in Prague. So that's what's on my lips, which also fits really well, I think. It's nice and matte. Yeah, it stays on. It's not transferable. That's good. I haven't used it in a while. So yeah. If you like this video and if you want to follow all the others, it would be amazing. Please subscribe to all of them. Like all of them. Give everyone a comment. It would be amazing, including me, of course. And I love you all. I had so much fun again. Yeah, it's going to be a voiceover because... these kind of looks needs concentration and not just talking about blending and just blend it. I love it. I hope you enjoyed it with me. I hope you loved it with me. And I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.